Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's topic is about ratio analysis. In the last previous video, I explained about how to prepare the financial statements. So in this class, I'm going to explain about the ratio analysis. See, once the financial statements of an organization are prepared, then the businesses or need to be analyzed that financial statements. The tool to analyze and assess the financial statement of any firm is any ratio analysis. It helps to stakeholders or any managers or any employers to understand the current scenario of any business. So let us take a detailed look of any ratio analysis. The ratio analysis is a comparison of two numbers or two accounts. So the ratio analysis is a quantitative method. It processes and determines and interprets the numerical relationship based on the financial statements. A ratio is a statistical tool that provides a measurement of any relationship between the variables. Now, the ratio analysis was categorized into any four types. The first one is any liquidity ratio, solvency ratio, profitability ratio, and efficiency ratio. The solvency ratio, we also call it as any financial leverage ratio. And efficiency ratio, we also call it as any activity ratio or turnover ratio. Now, one after the other, we will go through with each and every type of any, every category of any ratio. The first ratio is any liquidity ratio. The meaning of liquidity means it's an availability. So liquidity defines the easily conversion of any assets or securities stock into any hard cash. So the liquidity ratio helps the businesses in measuring a company's short-term debts. The next ratio is any solvency ratio. The solvency ratio, it helps the business will serve for any long-term period or not. And it helps to evaluate the company's abilities to pay the long-term loans and debts for any business. So, if we see the meaning of an insolvency, it indicates the ability of any company to meet its debts or long-term loans. This solvency ratio, we'll also call it as any leverage ratio. The solvency ratio, it measures the asset value of any business. And the next ratio is any profitability ratio. The profit is any main objective of any business. So all businesses are running for sake of any profit itself. So this ratio are used to know the profitability of any business. By using this ratio, it convey the how well the company can generate the profits from its operations. In a profit margin, in the form of return on assets, return on equity, return on capital employed, and gross margin ratio or any net profit ratio, and so on and so. So here, by using these ratios, the company is able to know that if the company was get in the profit or if the company is in the loss position. And the next ratio is an efficiency ratio. The efficiency ratio, we also call it as an activity or turnover ratio. It measures the efficiency of any firm by based on the converting their semi-finished goods or any finished goods, and finally they will sell in the market and they will make it into any cash. So here, this efficiency ratio, it measures the how smartly they are producing the semi-finished good or any finished good, and how they are making it as any money. Let me see the what's the formulas for each and every category of any ratio. See, under the liquidity ratio, there are any two formulas. One is a current ratio and another one is a quick ratio. The current ratio formula is a current assets divided by current liability. So here, what's the use of a current ratio means? It indicates the ability of a short-term solvency of a firm. And next ratio is a quick ratio. The quick ratio formula is a current assets minus stock divided by current liability. The stock is nothing but as an inventory. This formula helps the business to know the short-term solvency of any firm. And next ratio is an solvency ratio. Under the solvency ratio, there is an debt equity ratio. The formula is an total liabilities divided by shareholder equity. So this formula helps the business to know the long-term financial policies of any business. And the next formula is under solvency ratio is an proprietary ratio. This formula is an shareholders equity divided by total assets into an 100. This formula helps the to know the business soundness regarding the capital structure. And the next formula is an profitability ratio. For knowing the profitability of any company or any business, they can use this profitability ratio. Under the profitability ratio, there is an net profit ratio. The formula is an net profit divided by net sales, means total sales, into an 100. And next formula is an gross profit ratio. The gross profit ratio is equals to total gross profit divided by net sales into an 100. Next formula under the profitability ratio is an net operating ratio. The formula is operating cost divided by net sales into an 100. And the next ratio is an activity ratio. We can call it as a turnover ratio. Under this ratio, there is an inventory turnover ratio. The formula for this is an cost of goods sold divided by average inventory. How to know the cost of goods sold means here the opening stock plus purchases minus closing stock, we can get the cost of goods sold amount. For average inventory, we want to add the opening stock plus closing stock divided by 2 if we get the average inventory. For closing stock, opening stock plus purchases minus closing stock. For knowing the average inventory, opening stock plus closing stock divided by 2, then we'll get as an average inventory. Okay, next formula is an receivable turnover ratio. This formula is an net credit sales divided by average trade receivables. This receivable turnover ratio helps in knowing how many times the credit is collected in a given period of any time. Guys, let me solve one simple problem which is related to the liquidity ratio. The question is like this. This is a balance sheet as on 31st March, and these are the liabilities items and then assets items. So by using these items, we want to calculate the current ratio and then quick ratio. First, we'll calculate the current ratio. The formula for any current ratio is any current assets divided by current liabilities. Guys, again, I was repeating that current assets are nothing but the assets which are easily converted into any hot cash within a 3 to 6 months of any time. For an example, cash at bank means we can easily withdraw the cash from a bank, and the bills receivables means we can collect our money from our credit sellers, and next we can receive amount from any debitors. And the stock means stock is nothing but inventory. By using the stock also, we can convert that stock into any cash within a short span of any time. And coming to any current liabilities, the current liability means the amount due to pay within a short span of any time. We can consider it as any current liability. For an example, sundry creditor, it's any payables or any short term loans, all of these items comes under the current liabilities. Okay, guys, first we'll identify what are the current assets in this items. First, we have any current land and building is an asset, fixed asset. Plant and machinery, it is also a fixed asset. Stock is nothing but inventory, so stocks we can easily convert into any cash, so it is any current asset. And debitors, we can receive amount from our lenders. And next, receivables. So if we sell our goods on credit basis, means from them also we can receive our cash and we can easily withdraw the cash from bank. So here we identify the four items which are comes under the current assets. If we add all these current assets, 2 lakhs plus 1 lakh plus 10,000 and 40,000, we will get total as any 3,50,000. And next we'll identify what are the current liabilities items. So here we have any capital, is there not any current one? P&L also, it is not current liability. General reserves, it is also for in a long term. Debentures for in a long term. So sundry creditors, yes. If we purchased goods on credit basis, means we want to pay to the suppliers within a short span, and the payables also same. So here if we add the 1 lakh and 50,000, means we'll get 1,50,000. So if we deduct, sorry, if we divide the current assets, means 3,50,000 with any 1,50,000, we can get the ratio as any 2.33:1, means it indicate as any here the 2.33 is any assets and this one is any liability, means the assets are more than a liability, this company having the assets more than any liabilities. Okay, now we'll calculate the quick ratio. The formula for any quick ratio is any current assets minus inventory divided by liability. So guys, we already got the value of any current assets is any 3,50,000. Next, minus inventory. Inventories are nothing but as any stock. The stock value is any 2 lakhs. So for here, for a quick ratio, we want to deduct the current asset. Sorry, we want to deduct the stock from any current assets. So if you deduct 3,50,000 minus 2 lakhs, we'll get as any 1,50,000. And the current liability is any, already we calculated, it's as any 1,50,000. So here, if 1,50,000 divided by 1,50,000, we'll get the ratio as any 1:1 ratio. Means it indicate as any quick ratio is equals to 1% of any current asset and then 1% of any current liability. That is also in a one indicator, it's in a good indicator for any company. Okay, like this we'll calculate all the ratios guys. In the next video I will solve the solvency ratio and profitability ratio and then efficiency ratio. Thank you guys.